success for this offense. And, you know, I'm just hoping that because of tight end, we can keep creating that spark in the tight end room and the type of mismatch that we can have out there on the field. So league wide, we can really get the position that much more ingrained in the offenses.
Travis, to your left here. Could you take us back a little bit to the offseason workouts with Pat and some of the new receivers in Texas and how helpful that was as you kind of went through the grind of the season?
Yeah, I mean, it was Pat's idea to get everybody going before we got into OTAs. And you know what, I think that all that did was really just get the ball rolling and get everybody in the same mind frame. They kind of saw how me and Pat, how McCole was down there, Clyde Edwards-Helaire was down there working their tails off, and they saw the practice habits there. And then that was just the easy way to transition right into OTAs when we got the coaches involved and the entire team together. But, you know, it was as much as we like to say it's about a culture here, you can't say enough about the guys that came in that took this to heart, man. You know, it's cool looking back on it now because you see the determination, you see the focus, you see the want to get to a position that we're in. And, man, it's gratifying for sure. But I don't think enough is said about the professionals that came in, the guys that came in this year with the right mindset each and every single day, even when, you know, we weren't even clocking in with the Chiefs. We were just trying to figure out how we were going to make this thing work.
Hey, Travis, over here to your – You're right.
Right on.
We know how much Patrick Mahomes has meant in your career with NFL honors today and him being up for the MVP award and him winning one his second year. What's it mean to you to see the evolution of him from that first MVP year to now being a favorite to win the MVP and seeing how he's evolved over this year in comparison to that first MVP season he had?
I think we just seen him grow as a quarterback. His talent level goes far beyond more than his ability to instinctually just go out there. You know, he's playing a step ahead. He's almost playing chess out there in terms that he's got three or four moves already in his pocket, depending on what the defense does. And you know, that's what's going to make him the greatest to ever go down. And I love playing with him. And he's nonstop, always trying to find ways to make himself better for this team. And you saw that. More so this year than any other year that we've played, knowing that the pieces were a little bit different in terms of the weapons that he has and the scrutiny that everybody was kind of looking to see how he was going to take his game to the next level. And sure enough, I'm pretty sure he'll win MVP.
Morning, Trav. Morning. Are you always open?
Why am I always open? I say it all the time. Andy Reid, baby. Big Red, he can dial some stuff up at the right time, create some things at the right time, and then on top of that, you know, everybody is doing their job. It's not just me just go out there and get open kind of play. I'm sure you guys like to think that, but there's a lot of madness to it, and there's a lot of guys doing their job for the big picture, and I'm fortunate that I'm playing here for sure.
You talked about the new guys and the important role they play in this Super Bowl. Obviously not the result y'all wanted last time in the Super Bowl. Do you use that as motivation this week? Do you tell them what it's like to lose a Super Bowl in the build-up to this one?
I don't even like to revisit that one. I'll tell you what, that wasn't a prideful moment in my life. But I'll tell you what, it's it's good wisdom to have. And as a leader, I don't think that I stepped up to the plate as much as I should have in that game. And that's where it really burns me. So I'm just focusing on myself to be able to be the best leader that I can, the best teammate that I can come game day. And, yeah, not put my team in a position like I did the last time we were in the Super Bowl.
Right here. Travis, right over here. Given it's year 10 for you, what did you feel like was your toughest challenge this season and what was necessary to overcome it to get to this point?
Every single season has their challenges, and I feel like this year for me it was keeping the body at full strength. That was probably the biggest thing for me. You know, week in, week out, you always try and get back to 100%, and you know, and in this league, towards the end of the season, especially with the 17th game now, man, it's tough to try and get back to that top, like, physical form. And especially the older you get. I'm sure everybody can account to that. But it's there's that aspect, and then the challenge of the injuries around you and things like that. But for the most part, for me, it was week in, week out, trying to get my body back to playing in the best physical form that I can.
Travis, you talked a minute ago about Pat maybe winning an MVP. What would that mean to you and really the rest of the guys in the locker room if he did win that award?
Really, it's just it's something that I know at the end of his career he's going to be able to hang his hat on, but Pat doesn't walk into that building thinking I need to be the MVP. He walks into that building trying to find the best way to beat the opponent that we have that week. And he just goes out there and he plays the style of football that he does. He has fun doing it with the guys that he has around him, and we rally around that. We rally around that excitement, that want for and that desire to win with the guys next to us, man. It just makes coming into the building that much more fun.
Travis here in the middle. Hi. You and Patrick Mahomes have a very special relationship, and you've talked a lot about the play-by-play mentality. With Mahomes coming off an injury and having a harder time getting out of the pocket, how are you and the rest of the offensive line planning on creating opportunities to move the ball down the field?
Yeah, I mean, that defensive line is arguably the best in the game this year, and a big reason why they're here in the Super Bowl. And it's going to be a big task, but I know our offensive line, everybody that's in the run game and pass game in terms of having to deal with the front and protecting Pat, we're all pretty locked in on the task at hand. And we know it's going to be a challenge. We know that they got some real dogs up front. And even if they get to Pat once or twice, man, we got to find a way to still move the ball downfield and have success.
Ruth Biggis with KC Cares. You and your brother are having a lot of fun with this. You're setting history. What's important about that situation, and what do you have to say for the folks back in Cleveland who are your second biggest fans?
I'll tell you what, I love Cleveland to death. The east side of Cleveland, where I grew up, is it's given me so much in terms of my passion for sports, my passion for life, my passion for the friends and family that I have around me. And I know the Heights is proud. We're representing you guys in the biggest stage that we could possibly represent you on. And it's just there's a lot of pride for not only the city but the people back home. We'll go out there and try and get a win. But I think it'll mean a little bit more if the Chiefs win. That's just me being a little biased.
All right, we got three more. Young lady here, Sam, Albert.
Yeah, hey, Travis. This is sort of playing off Diana's question about always being open. Chad told me a couple weeks ago that he thinks it's because you were a high school quarterback and you know how to set up coverage, you understand leverage, all of that. How much does that experience having played quarterback in high school play into the player you are at tight end now?
Initially, I really didn't – going into the tight end position, it was a pretty big struggle. I'm not going to lie. I didn't feel comfortable running routes. I didn't feel comfortable blocking. It took really a full year to 2 years, up until my senior year in college, to really kind of hone my own craft. And then it changed as soon as I got to the league. I went from really being a wide tight end, an inline tight end, to kind of this new creation that you see Coach Reed and the offensive staff really creating for me in this offense. And making that transition, I think, yeah, you have an understanding of what that quarterback is going through back there. You have an understanding of the progression on this play. You have the understanding of, all right, versus this defense, this is where I need to go with the ball. And if you have that kind of mindset, if you're in the quarterback's mind and you're thinking with him and the chemistry is there, there's certain things you can do when you run routes to get open or to just make that guy's life that much easier. And that's my job. My job is to go out there and paint a picture for the quarterback to make his job that much easier, a clear-cut, decisive picture of where to go with the ball. And from that point on, as soon as I get it in my hands, it's just that's when the fun starts. So it's just, you know, I guess being a quarterback definitely helped out a lot because I get to understand the conversations and the things that are going on in that quarterback's head. But at the end of the day, I feel like everybody's got to have that quarterback mentality or that quarterback mindset on reading the defense and adjusting depending on what they're presenting.
Hey, Travis, you spoke a couple days ago about the support that you received from some of the Cincinnati coaches the year that you weren't playing. What mm-hmm. kind of role did your brother play, too, in that and the support that you received from him?
Man, I when I got removed from the team, I got my scholarship took, so I was actually staying with my brother. I was in his room in his house, kind of like two brothers growing up living in the same room. So in terms of rent, I wasn't paying rent. In terms of food, he was helping me with food. So I was literally living off him for quite a while down there, and he was my lifeline. And that being said, every single day I was trying to do the right things. And he went into the coach's office and actually talked to numerous coaches and numerous people in the Cincinnati staff to try and get me another chance to be on the team. And I'm forever in debt to this guy for putting his name, our name, you know, just putting his honor on the line to give me another chance. And so when I say I owe it all to him, I really do.
Sam.
Travis, earlier to a question, you said not put your team in the same position you did last time you were in the Super Bowl. What do you mean by that? And is that something that's obviously stuck with you for the past couple of years?
I mean, through through every single game, you're going to have those ups and downs. And unfortunately, we had a lot of challenges early on, and I don't think I handled it the best as a leader in terms of stepping up to the plate, helping control the mindset, making a big time play to spark some energy, to spark that momentum. There were a few plays early on there that I just didn't feel like I did my job, and then on the sideline, in terms of the energy and the motive and the demeanor of the team, that's where I really think I could help out as well.
Last question in the back.
Travis, we saw what happened in the NFC Championship game when this 49ers season gets derailed because of injuries at the quarterback position. People have talked about you, the possibility of you having to be emergency quarterback. What about Blake Bell? Who's the better quarterback in that room?
I'm going to say Blake Bell by a landslide, man. He's actually gone in a college game, and I believe it was Oklahoma versus Oklahoma State, I think. He went down there, a two-minute drive or something like that. I've seen a little bit of the highlights, and I've seen him play. And just throwing it around on the field. Yeah, I'm taking Blake Bell over me for sure.
Thank you.
Have a good one, guys.